afternoon, everyone. And welcome to the SDCJ. I'm the new president, Isabel Reynolds, and I'm delighted to welcome our guest speaker today, Shigeru Ishiba, one of the three candidates to become the next prime minister of Japan. I'd like to point out that at this point, we invited all three candidates to join us at the club. Mr. Ishiba was the only one kind enough to accept our offer, or brave enough, perhaps. He really needs no introduction, but I'd just like to go through a few of his career highlights. He's a former defense minister, a former minister for regional revitalization, and of course, in the last months and years, possibly the most outspoken critic within the LDP of the Abe administration, something that's made him very popular with the public, and indeed, for most of this year, the most popular option to succeed Mr. Abe. So Mr. Ishiba is going to speak for about 20 minutes, and we'll follow that with a Q&A session. So without further ado,
Mr. Ishiba. All right. ご機会いただきまして誠にありがとうございます。衆院議員の石破茂であります。今ネクストプライムミニスターというお話がありました。第一義的には自民党総裁選挙なので、冒頭自民党いかにあるべきかということを短時間お話したいと存じます。
So good afternoon. Thank you very much. I'm very glad to have the opportunity to be here to speak to you today. As introduced, my name is Shigeru Ishiba. I'm a member of the House of Representatives of Japan. In the introduction now, we heard that I'm a candidate for the next prime minister. But of course, the first stage we have now is the election for the presidency of the LDP. So I would first like to briefly share some of my thoughts about how the LDP should be moving forward.
10年前、私どもは野党を3年3ヶ月経験をいたしました。麻生内閣で解散をして、私当時農林水産大臣でしたが、ちょうど300あった衆議院の議席が119になって、壊滅的な敗北を喫して矢に下ったのであります。
So, actually just 10 years ago we experienced, the LDP experienced 3 years and 3 months being in the opposition. This was following the dissolving of the cabinet under the Aso government, and I was a member of the government at that time as well. Then we went from approximately 300 seats in the parliament to 119, so there was a drastic drop.
谷垣貞一さんが総裁になられ、私はその下で政務調査会長を務めておりました。
And so following this, there was a change in the presidency of the LDP, and I became head of the policy committee within the LDP.
政党ですから、何をするための政党なのか、いかなる政党なのか、それを定めた党の綱領、党の決まり、憲法のようなものですね、それがあるのですが、それを作り直しました。
And at that time, thinking about, well, as a political party, what we should be aiming for, what form we should be taking, what nature the party should be taking on, we decided to create the new, well, policy platform, or almost like a constitution for the political party at that time, was newly revised.
そこにはこのように記しました。自由民主党は勇気を持って自由活発に、まあ、自由と訳していただいてもいいんですが、に真実を語る政党である。
And during, in this new revised version of the policy platform, we stated that the LDP would be a party which would speak courage, freedom, and truth.
自由民主党はあらゆる組織と協議する政党である。
That the LDP would be a party which would conduct debate with all organizations, all institutions.
自由民主党は国会を公正に運営し、政府を謙虚に機能させる政党である。
And that there would be fair management of the diet, and that the government management would also be done in a humble manner.
自由民主党の政府は政策を作るにあたり、条件を作るにあたり、あらゆる人に公平な政党である。
That the LDP government would be in the process of creating policies and creating various conditions, would be a party that would be fair to all people.
自民党は新しい政党として生まれ変わり、国民に審判を受けたい。その思いで安倍総裁、私はその下で幹事長を務めておりましたが、総選挙を戦い、政権を奪還したのであります。
And so at that time, looking at how to be reborn as a new party, a new version of the LDP, and then to be judged by the people in this new state, this new form. It was in this form that Mr. Abe took on the presidency of the party, and I became its secretary general, and it was through this that we were able to have success in the general election and regain the government.
自由民主党は勇気を持って自由闊達に真実を語る、そしてあらゆる組織と協議をする、そして国会を公正に運営し、政府を謙虚に機能させる、そしてあらゆる人に公平な条件づくり、政策づくりをする、それを忘れてはならない、今それを忘れていないか、そしてそういう党になる、そう言って政権をお預かりしたのではないか、自由民主党はそういう党でありたい、私は強く願うものであります。
So in summary, the LDP is a party which speaks courage, freedom and truth, which debates with all institutions, which fairly runs the parliament, which humbly has a functioning government, which has fair conditions for all people in regards to creating policies. I question actually whether as the LDP has really been able to maintain that, or are we somehow forgetting this along the way? And I believe that this is something which we must come back to, which we must remember as well, and therefore keeping to hold us to this.
今の時代を100年に一度の激動の時代だという方がありますが、お見受けする限り100年前に生きていた人は一人もいない。
And、so there are of course some people who say that this、now era, this new period we're entering is you know, one crisis in 100 years. However,、whether this is a question or not is something.
100年前というのはどういう時代であったか。1914年から18年まで第一次世界大戦である。
And of course if we think back to what kind of world we had 100 years ago, this was during the period 1914 to 1918 when the world was amidst the First World War.
1918年から20年までスペイン風邪が猛威を振るい、世界で1億人の人が命を落としたと言われている。
And following this, of course, the period of 1918 to 1920 was when the world was in the midst of the chaos caused by the Spanish influenza. And at this time, 100 million people are thought to have lost their lives.
日本でも40万人以上が死んだ。
In Japan, also 400,000 people lost their lives through the Spanish flu.
そして1929年は世界大恐慌の始まりである。
And then, of course, from 1929, we saw the world falling into the Great Recession as well.
1939年から49年まで第二次世界大戦である。
And from 1939, World War II.
これが100年前の出来事である。
Of course, these are the main events that were happening in the world 100 years ago.
我々は世界大戦争など決して起こしてはならない。
So first of all, we need to ensure that such these global wars, these world wars, are not repeated.
ウイルスによって大勢の人が命を落とすようなことはあってはならない。
We must also prevent there being this massive loss of lives as well through a virus or such an epidemic.
世界大恐慌など決して起こしてはならん。
And also ensure that there will not also be this modern recession on this great global scale as well.
100年前に学ぶというのはそういうことなのである。
So it's very important for us to be learning from what happened, what the world was experiencing 100 years ago.
平成の30年とは何であったか。その検証をしなければ令和を語ることはできない。
And if we look back also to the 30 years of the Heisei period, looking at what should be continued or learned from this is necessary in order to look towards the Reiwa era.
昭和が終わったとき、私は当選1回生だった。
At the time when the Showa era ended, I was in my first term.
昭和とは何であったかということを徹底的に考えたし、日本人の多くがそうである。
And I think that this was a period when we were looking at, well, what was the Showa era? What was happening in Japan? And this is something which many Japanese people were questioning.
平成とは何であったのか。一つは戦後が終わったのが平成である。
And so what was the Heisei era? Well, one of the main factors there was, of course, that it was the first, the post-war era. It was when Japan really entered the post-war period.
私を政治の世界に導いてくださった故田中角栄元総理は、一兵卒、一人の兵隊として日中戦争に従軍をされた。
And if we look towards the former Prime Minister Tanaka Kakue, who of course had a formational role in building this era as well, he was someone who had been a soldier during the Sino-Japanese War.
田中角栄先生は生前にこう語っておられた。And while he... あの戦争に行ったやつが世の中の中心にいるうちは日本の国は大丈夫である。
And what Mr. Tanaka said while he was still alive was that as long as those people who experienced the war firsthand are still with us and are at the center of Japan, at the center of politics, then things will be all right.
戦争に行ったやつが世の中の中心からいなくなる時が怖いので、よく若い人たちは勉強しなさいと言っておられる。
And so he said that once we reach the era, the period when these people who did firsthand go to war, experience war, are no longer at the center, then this is something to be afraid of. Therefore, young people must study and learn very hard.
私は1957年、戦争が終わって12年経って生まれている。
I was born in 1957, so 12 years after the end of the war.
1945年に15歳で兵隊に行った人も今や90歳。
Those people who in 1945 went to war as 15-year-olds, of course, are now 90 years old.
後ほどお話をするが、私は憲法改正は前の戦争に行った人が生き残っているうちにやりたい。戦争を知らないものばかりで憲法の改正をやりたいとは全く思わないということは、ここ20年ずっと言い続けている。
I will speak more to this later, but I believe and I am aiming to achieve the or to go forward with amendment of the Constitution while we still have those people who experienced the war with us, while they are still alive. And this is something which I have been saying for the past 20 years as well, that this constitutional discussion and amendment must be done while they are still with us.
なぜ戦争になったのか、それは猪瀬直樹さんの昭和16年。1941年ですね。昭和16年夏の敗戦、なぜ日本人は戦争をしたかという本、今でもリニューアルされて、文庫本で本屋さんに積んであるが、その本に明らかである。
And so if we look to why the war actually started at that time, I believe that a very strong reference for that is to look at the book which was written by Inose Naoki, which about the Showa 16 or 1941 and how Japan was acting at that time as well. This book has been recently renewed and is in the bookstores, and this I think is a good point to look at as to questioning why it was that the war came about.
昭和16年、日本政府は陸軍、海軍、ありとあらゆる官庁、日本銀行、同盟通信、30歳代の最もできるエリートを集めて、アメリカと戦争したらどうなるか、徹底的なシミュレーションを行う。
And in this book, he's looking at in the year 1941, if the Japanese government, looking at those who were at the top of the army, the navy, the Japanese bank, all of these different institutions as well, these elites, if Japan had gone to war with the US at thatstage, carrying out a thorough simulation of this situation.
経済規模は8倍違う。鉄鋼の生産量は10倍違う。自動車の生産台数は100倍違う。すべての正確なデータが彼らに与えられた。
And within this scenario, he also puts forward figures such as that the scale of the economy would have been 8 times, of manufacturing 10 times, of automobile manufacturing 100 times. These very accurate figures within this different scenario.
1941年夏、結論は出た。絶対に勝てないので、どんな理由があろうとこの戦争はしてはならないということが結論だ。
And looking at this, so looking at this scenario as of summer 1941, it comes to the definitive conclusion that if it would not have been, it would not be possible to win in such a war with the US.
彼らの結論は取り上げられることがなかった。
His conclusion was not taken up.
国民は誰もそのようなデータを知らなかった。
The people were not aware of such data.
メディアは権力と結託して戦争を煽った。
The media was completely attached to authority and encouraging the war.
陸軍も海軍も予算を減らされることを恐れて戦争はできないとは言わなかった。
The army and the navy fearing a reduction in their budget also did not say that it was not possible or wise for them to go to war.
議会も保身に走り反対を叫んだ者はごくごく少数であり、反対を叫ぶ演説をした者は衆議院を除名された。
The parliament was also completely in this direction as well, and those few minority voices who did raise their opposition to going in the war as well had their names removed from the parliament.
その時の議事録は今なお削除されたままである。
The minutes from that time are also still deleted.
戦争を起こしてはならないというのはそういうことである。
This is what I am talking about when I say that we should not allow a war again.
正しい情報が与えられることだ、正しい言論があることだ、議会が勇気を失わないことだ、この利益に走らないこと。
This means having accurate information, having a strong and accurate debate, also that the parliament will have the courage as well.
第二に、民主主義が終わったとは言わないが、大きく変質を遂げたのが平成という時代である。
The second major factor of the Heisei period as well is the fact that there was a very strong shift or transfer in the nature of democracy.
参加する資格のある人ができるだけ大勢参加しなければ民主主義は機能しない。
Democracy, of course, only functions when as many people as possible or when a large amount of those who are eligible for participation in politics do participate.
参加する人を制限してはならないし、大勢の人が無関心になって投票率が下がることがあってもならない。
So there must not be limitations put on their participation in this way, and we should also not have the kind of situation where people are losing their interest in politics and therefore the voting rates fall.
正しい情報が伝えなければならないし、記録が改ざんされたり破棄されたりして民主主義は機能しない。
So accurate information must always be conveyed, and having minutes and so on being either amended or deleted and so on is also a situation which must not be allowed under democracy.
そして少数意見が尊重されなければ民主主義は機能しない。
Democracy also does not function unless the opinions of the minority are also respected.
かつてウィンストン・チャーチルが民主主義は最悪の政治制度だ、今まであったあらゆる政治制度を除けばという言葉を残した。
And of course, Winston Churchill left down a very famous word saying that, well, democracy, it has perhaps been, I'm not sure the exact quote, sorry, but it's the worst situation, but it's the best one that we have that's actually functioned.
我々は民主主義が正しく機能するようにさらに努力をしていかねばならない。
Therefore, we must accurately or take efforts to make sure that democracy does function in an accurate and an effective as way as possible.
資本主義が大きく変質を遂げたのも平成の30年である。
It was also in the 30 years of the Heisei period that capitalism also underwent a great transformation.
株主が優先される資本主義になってしまった。
And became a situation where the shareholders hold the greatest priority.
金融が大きく全体を左右する資本主義になってしまった。
And unfortunately, it became a kind of capitalism where finance also had a huge impact on how things developed.
株を持てる人や大企業は非常に利益を得たが、そうでない人々は貧しいままに残されている。
So those people who either had a great number of shares or the large corporations could benefit as a result of this system, but those others became poorer and were left out.
格差と分断は資本主義が行き着く一つの姿である。
So these forms of division and also gaps between people is one thing which has developed through this system of capitalism.
しかしこれを是正していかねばならない。
However, this itself must be fixed.
再配分の機能を取り戻していかねばならない。
We need to take back also the functions for redistribution.
会社は株主や経営者だけのものではない。
Corporations belong not only to their shareholders or their executives.
従業員のものであり、家族のものであり、社会のためのものである。
Corporations also must belong to their employees, their families, and to society at large.
これを公益資本主義と名付けるが、それがさらに日本において発展するようにしていかなければならない。
So this is a form of capitalism which is also forming the public benefit, and this is something which we need to be developing even further here in Japan.
利益だけを求めることなく、地域のいろんな自然の資源を循環させる里山資本主義。これは日本だけの言葉かもしれないが、これをサブシステムとして機能させなければならない。
So rather than a form of capitalism which relies or which is pursuing only profits, we need to also be looking at how it can become a system which is respecting the cycle of natural resources. We could perhaps refer to this in the Japanese context as a Satoyama capitalism, or looking at the broader ecosystem and the natural situation.
残余の時間でいくつかの論点について語りたい。
So there are several last points I would like to mention just to close my initial remarks.
コロナの収束を図るためには特別措置法の改正を検討し実行すべきだと私は思う。
First of all, in order to bring the COVID-19 situation under control, I believe that there must be some changes made to the special measures law.
感染が収束したら特措法の改正をするというのは間違っている。
And so to make these changes to the law after the situation has already been brought under control, I do not believe is the way to go.
確かに重症者は減ってきただろう。しかしそれは医療の現場の過酷な努力によるものであって、医療崩壊の危険は常にある。
We are indeed seeing a reduction in the number of seriously ill cases in regards to COVID-19. However, this is thanks to the dedicated efforts of the medical and health professionals. And we are always, or we are constantly facing this danger of the collapse of the medical system.
医療現場に対する支援は必要である。
We need further support for those in the field, in medical and health.
強制的な措置を導入しなければならないとすれば、経済的支援が必要である。
If we do need to have mandatory measures brought in place, then also economic support must be introduced at the same time.
対応はできるだけ地方に任せるべきである。
And also, as much as possible, the response should be left to the regional governments as well.
アベノミクスは株価を上昇させ、企業の利益を最大にし、企業の貯金を最大にし、有効求人倍率を引き上げた。それは素晴らしいことであった。
If we refer to Abenomics, of course, this has had the success in having a huge increase in the share values, also looking for the profits for corporations and the savings which these large corporations can introduce as well. And this is, of course, something which is to be respected, which is to be regarded.
しかし一方において GDP で比較したときに、Abenomics がスタートしたときに、日本と中国の経済規模は中国が日本の 1.4 倍であったのが今 2.9 倍になっている。
However, if we compare, for example, the GDP of Japan and China at the time that the Abenomics policy first started, at that initial stage, it was 1.4 times the amount. China was 1.4. However, now we see it is 2.9 times.
アメリカとの比較で言えば、アベノミクスが始まったときに日米の経済規模は 2.6 倍の差があったのだが、今4倍の規模に開いている。
And if we compare with the United States, for example, at the start of Abenomics, there was a difference of 2.6 times the size of the economy in regards to the GDP. However, now this has reached 4 times.
金利は低く、円は安く、減税をし、そして労働者の賃金は安い。そのことによってこの数字がもたらされたところがあるのではないだろうか。
And I believe that these kind of figures have been brought about and maintained also by having the low or the decrease in the yen, also looking at the decreasing in tax rates and so on, but also the lower wages for workers as well.
有効求人倍率は確かに全ての県で1を超えただろう。しかしながらそこにおいて女性、高齢者、非正規、そのような立場の人たちの雇用が増えたのではないか。
And if we look, of course, at the number of the unemployment rates or the number of unemployment rates which are filled in each prefecture, of course, this has reached a level of more than one. However, if we look, break this down to look at also employment rates or unemployment rates, sorry, of women, of the elderly, or of people who are employed in non-full-time or irregular employment as well, we still see that there is serious issues here.
それぞれの持てる潜在的な成長力、これを最大限に伸ばす、生産性を上げるというのはそういうことである。
And so if we look at how to increase productivity, we need to look at how to maximize this potential growth, this potential capacity.
デフレが続くのは賃金が上がらないからだ。
The reason that deflation is continuing is because wages are also not increasing.
金融政策だけでデフレが脱却するとは私は思っていない。
And I don't believe that we can break out of this just through finance or fiscal policies.
憲法についてはご質問があれば後ほどお答えしたいと思っているが、今自民党が4項目を提示しているが、それは党議決定したものでも何でもない。
And in regards to the Constitution, I would like to speak more in detail to that if there are any questions following this as well. However, the four main categories or points which are being raised by the LDP, I'd like to stress that they are not necessarily ones which have gone through the thorough consensus within the party yet.
私は憲法の改正は国民の広い理解のもとに行われるべきものであり、その努力を議会も自民党も怠ってはならない。
I believe that constitutional amendment is something which should be conducted after reaching the broad understanding of the people. And this is something which both the Diet and also the LDP should take efforts towards.
21世紀は世界の人口が倍になり、日本の人口が半分になる時代である。
The 21st century is a time when the global population will double, but the Japanese population will halve.
一つ直下型地震は必ず来るのだ。いつ来るかの問題であって、来るか来ないかの問題ではない。南海トラフも一緒だ。
And the potential of the earthquakes both directly under the Tokyo metropolitan area and also in the Nankai Trough as well, they're not an issue of whether it will happen, but rather when.
東京に全てのものが集中するとリスクを我々はもっと認識しなければならない。
We need to be more aware of the risk which is posed by centering everything here in Tokyo.
防災省を作るというのはそのような考え方に基づくものである。
And so my suggestion that we need to build a ministry for disaster response or disaster prevention is based upon this belief.
第一産業であり、中小企業であり、女性であり、地域の持てる潜在力を最大限に引き出し、東京の抱えるリスクを減らしていかねばならない。
We need to look at how we can maximize the possibility of primary industry, of women, of the potential capacity in the regional areas of Japan in order to restore and reduce these risks.
我々は一人一人が居場所のある日本、一人一人が自分たちは何のために生きているのか、一人一人の存在が認識され、一人一人が大切にされる、そういう日本を作りたい。日本の設計図を根幹から書き換える時期であり、それがグレートリセットである。
We also need to build a Japan where everybody feels that they have a sense of belonging, where everybody can feel their purpose, that they are recognized and that they are valued. And this can be said for each and every person within the country. In order to do this, I think we really need to rebuild Japan from the bottom up. And this is what I am referring to as the Great Reset.
今回のコロナはそれを我々に警告し、示唆してくれるものである。
And COVID-19 is indeed a warning bell for us towards this.
デジタルの技術はそのことを一層推進するものに役立つものであり、省庁を作るというよりも省庁横断的なデジタル全体を統括、そういう役職を設けたいと思っている。
And digital equipment, digital innovation and so on is something which can promote or push us further towards this direction, which can encourage this as well. Rather than looking at setting up new agencies and so on, I think that we need to look at also how to utilize these digital tools to have the across the board or across different agencies and ministries and so on to make more effective in this way.
政治は感動が必要である。
Politics needs to have something moving about it.
国民は政治を信じていないだろう。
I believe that the people now perhaps do not believe in politics.
しかし政治が自らのためでなく、すべての人のために、次の時代のために、身を捨てて戦うときに必ず国民は感動し、時代は変わる。私はそのように信じている。
But of course, politics is not something to be conducted for its own sake. It is for the sake of all of the people and for the sake of the next era, for the sake of the future as well. And I believe that if we can hold this at the center, then we will be able to once again rebuild a kind of politics that people can believe in and that they can feel moved by.
時間超過しました。ごめんなさい。
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Well, before moving on to the questions,I'd just like to introduce the other people at the table, our wonderful interpreter Mary Joyce and Teddy Jimbo of our Professional Activities Committee. Regarding the questions, when you come up to ask a question at the microphone, please identify yourself, keep your question short, no speeches, please.
ではこれで質疑応答に入りますが、質問は前のマイクの方を使っていただければと思います。そして質問を一人につき一つの質問に限定してください。
Right. I'm going to take advantage of my seat to ask the first question.
じゃあまず司会から先に一つさせていただきます。
I wrote a story the other day about how there are no women in the LDP leadership race. Why are there no women? And when are we going to see a Japanese female prime minister?
先日ですね、記事で書かせていただいたんですけれども、今回の総裁選にも女性が立候補しているということはないですね。で、日本ではいつ女性の総理大臣が誕生すると思いますでしょうか？
それは占い師じゃないから分かんないわ。
So I'm not a fortune teller, so I can't say when.
しかし女性の議員が少ない国会議員もそう、地方議員もそう、それは幹事長の時にどうしたら増えるだろうかって考えたんだけど、増えない理由は間違いなくどっかにある。24時間365日労働だってこともあるだろう。プライバシーが全くないってこともあるだろう。しかしそれは外国においても似たような事情ではないのだろう。
However, of course, the fact that there is now no one in this race also reflects the fact that there is a lower number of women within the parliament and also within the regional representatives in government as well. During my time as Secretary General of the LDP, I was questioning how we can increase the number of women as well. And thinking about, of course, some of the possible reasons for this, it can be that this is a job which is, of course, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. It is a job without any privacy. But at the same time, we can look to other countries and see many women in these positions as well. And, of course, the challenges exist in these other countries too.
この国は縮小均衡のサイクルに入ってるんですね。
So Japan is currently in a cycle of shrinking equilibrium.
社会の構造が保たれたままにどんどんどんどん日本は小さくなっていってるんですね。
So with the same social systems and so on maintained in the same way, but these different scales is becoming smaller and smaller. It's shrinking.
これを打ち破るためには女性の能力を最大限に活用していかないと縮小均衡に歯止めはかからない。
However, I don't believe that it will be possible to put a stop to this shrinking equilibrium, to put a stop to this system and break through unless we are able to maximize the full potential of women.
女性が少ないね、困ったもんだねなんつって言っても20年以上になるけれど、これを国家の危機だと捉えて、私は何でもかんでも全力尽くすって言い方嫌いなんだけど、女性の能力を最大限に引き出すということを国家の最大目標の一つとして捉え、なぜそれが実現しないのかという理由を解明し、その除去をするところから始めた。
But of course, it's been more than 20 years since we have had this realization or been questioning about the problem of so few women in these positions as well. I believe that what's necessary now is to really recognize this as a national crisis or an issue really on a national level as well. And to think about on a national level how we can set a goal to be able to maximize the or make most use of the full capacity of women and to look at why it is that this has not to be.Not been possible to make sure that we have a full questioning or accountability of the reasons that this has not been successful.
Thank you. Okay. Yes, David.
David McNeil, freelance. Thanks for coming today. It was fascinating to hear you acknowledge the weaknesses of Abenomics. You acknowledge, you know, rising stock prices and corporate profits.But accept or lament that the benefits have not been spread widely. I'm just wondering what you would do differently to Abe-san. Would you, for example, take the most obvious route, which would be to tax corporations more stringently?
はい、マクリールと申します。先ほどアベノミクスの弱点についての話、非常に興味深く聞いてたんですけれども、もし、総裁そして総理大臣になったのであれば、安倍さんとどういうことを、違う方法で違うような政策を取っていくのかということをぜひ伺いしたいと思うんですけれども、例えばその企業の税率を変えるですとか、そういうことが一番分かりやすいかもしれないんですけれども、どういう政策を取られるでしょうか。
法人課税については一律法人税を引き上げるという政策が正しいと私は思わない。
So I don't necessarily believe that the correct answer will be to just across the board have an increase in the corporate tax rates.
企業活動はマーケットのあるところにおいて行われるのであって、税金が安いということがプライオリティとして上に来るとは思わない。
And so, of course, different activities of corporations, corporate activities happen in the places where they are indeed necessary, where it is wanted as well. So rather than just seeing a reduction in tax rates as something that can contribute to this, I don't necessarily think that that will connect.
そして一律に下げるということは不公平を生むものである。
Furthermore, if the change is done just across the board, the same rate for all, then that would also lead to different kinds of, well, gaps or injustices between the system.
非正規を減らす、女性の雇用を増やす、地方に本社の機能を移転する、新しいマーケットイン型の商品を開発する、そういう企業に対して優遇的な税制が敷かれるべきである。
So I believe that we need to look at how we can have incentives and so on for companies, for example, that reduce the number of irregular workers, that can increase the number of women working there, that can look at, for example, moving headquarter functions to regional parts of Japan outside of the capital, to look at new marketing products which can be created and so on, and that there should be then the incentives for companies which can introduce these kinds of aspects.
このまま推移すると20年後に介護費用は 2.4 倍になり、医療の費用は 1.7 倍になる。
If we continue as we are today in 25 years, we will see that the cost, the expenses for care will be 2.4 times and for medical aspects 1.7 times.
医療制度も介護制度もサステナブルではなくなる。
The medical and care systems, welfare systems and so on will not, well, they cannot be sustainable in this way.
安定的な財源が必要であり、そのために消費税は必要なものだと私は思う。
There needs to be stable resources in order to ensure that there can be sustainability in these aspects, and I think that the consumer tax is one relevant aspect to that.
コロナ対策に消費税の軽減を用いるべきではないし、消費税を一律に下げるという考え方に私は賛同しない。
And therefore, I do not believe that there should be a reduction in the consumer tax in order to respond to the COVID crisis, and I don't think that the overall or the across the board reduction there is the solution.
安定的な財源を確保するためには課税のベースを広げるということも選択肢だろう。
I believe that in order to ensure or secure the stable resources that will be needed, we also need to look at how to, when we're looking at the increasing the tax and so on, need to increase the base of what is there.
累進課税を法人も含めて見直すことも選択肢の一つだろう。
And so looking at how to do this across the board, not looking only at corporate tax, but the various aspects here and the broader aspects is important.
必要なのは所得の低い方、消費性向の低い方の所得を引き上げることである。あるいは地方の一次産業の女性のそういう方々の潜在力を引き出すために、ありとあらゆる税制は集中的に改善されるべきものであると考えています。
So I believe that the kinds of changes which should be made to the taxes and the kind of reforms which are needed should be targeting particular areas. For example, we can look at the relation or how people who have lower income or have lower consumer capacity and so on, but also how to increase and maximize the capacity of the regional parts of Japan, of primary industry, and also of bringing women into the workforce.
消費税の引き下げは高額所得者に大きな利益をもたらすのだということも忘れるべきではない。
And we must not forget also that an increase in consumption tax and consumer tax, of course, is something which is of a great benefit to those in the higher income brackets.
Okay, so Teddy.
Okay, I'm going to ask questions in Japanese. 石破さん、日本語で質問します。ビデオニュースの神保です。石破さん、先ほど民主主義の話をされましたけれども、私はむしろ自民党内の民主主義の問題についてお伺いしたいです。というのがですね、今回の総裁選というのはどういう総裁選の方式を取るかによって特定の候補が有利になったり不利になったりするということがあるにもかかわらず、なぜか幹事長一任という形になり、その幹事長が早くに特定の候補の支援を打ち出し、その打ち出した幹事長一任という形でこういう方式で決まったと。しかも党則に本来は総裁選をやると書いてあるけど、ただし緊急の場合にはというただし書きがあったので、まあこういう形で決まったと。そもそも石破さんがもし総裁になられたらば、このような形で非民主的な形で総裁が選ばれてしまうようなこの状態にある党について、どのように何を変えられるかというのが1点。それから今回じゃあこういう場合に、その緊急、ただし緊急の場合はとあるんですけども、その緊急の場合というのは今回は何だったのかと石破さんは考えてられるか、その2点お願いします。
My name is Jimbo. You mentioned about the situation of democracy. I would like to ask a question about democracy within the LDP itself, and particularly about the nature of the way that the vote for the presidential race in this election is being made as well, the structures there as well. Of course, there was the decision to carry out this election for the president of the LDP in a way that could be said to have, you know, a certain merit for particular candidates and so on. And this was something which was decided by the chief cabinet secretary, who is himself a candidate as well. The Secretary General. And looking also at the fact that this is, of course, listed that in an emergency situation, this kind of method can be pursued. But I'd like to ask two questions in relation to this. First of all, if you become the president of the LDP, what kind of changes or what kind of perspective would you have on a party which does select its head under such non-democratic processes? And the second part of a question is, in this particular case that we are experiencing now, how do you understand this? Or this viewing as an emergency situation?
後段からお答えすれば、緊急の場合というのは突如として総裁がいなくなっちゃったというような場合じゃないですかね。小渕さんがお倒れになったとか、これは選挙中でしたけどね、昭和55年に大平総理が亡くなっちゃったとかね、そういう場合が緊急なんでしょうね。
So to answer the last part first, well, what kind of a situation is an emergency? This is, of course, the kind of situation where the president of the party is no longer there or able to function. Situation, for example, as we've had in the past when Mr. Obuchi collapsed, or in the year 1980, for example, during the election period when Mr. Ohira passed away.
つまり臨時代理は立つにしても、総理がいなくなっちゃったと、総裁がいなくなっちゃったと。いうことは緊急の第一の要件でしょう。今そうじゃないからね。
And so I think that, well, this, it is this absence of the Prime Minister, which is indeed what we should understand as an emergency, and that was not, well, that's not the situation we are facing now.
あるいは社会状況がとても総裁選なんかやってるような状態ではない。つまり戦争があるとかね。あちらこちらで大災害が起こっているとかね。こうウイルスが蔓延してバタバタ人が死ぬの映画でありましたよね。首都感染とかね、そういう金映画があるんですけどね、本当にそういう状況で選挙なんかやってる場合じゃない、そういう状況のことを言うんでしょうね。今コロナは蔓延というかな、感染は止まっていないが、そも自民党の総裁選挙って郵便投票で行うんだよね。そこにおいて社会状況がそのような緊急な状態だとも判断はされない。
And the second understanding that we could make of this definition of emergency would be, well, if we were in a societal situation where carrying out such an election would be completely impossible. This would be, for example, if we were in the midst of a war, if there were immense natural disasters taking place, if the virus or pandemic was on a scale that there was massive loss of life taking place.You know, the kind of things that we see perhaps in films in these emergency situations as well. However, if we look, well, of course, the COVID-19 situation is not completely under control. However, the election for the LDP president is conducted by postal means. Therefore, I would not say that we are in such a critical or emergency societal situation.
政府の機能停止の避けねばならないっていうのは、かなり今頑張ってる安倍さんに対しては失礼な物言いだと私は思いますよ。
And I believe that actually to question whether the government can continue its strong functionings is something which is actually, well, questioning or being rather insensitive or rude to Mr. Abe, who is indeed carrying out in a very dedicated way his work now.
たらればの話をして恐縮だが、私は総裁になったとすれば、常に正規の選挙を行う。緊急というのは先ほど申し上げたようなごくごく限られた場合に限るのであって、党員の権利は最大限に尊重される。そして党員に正しい情報が量質ともに提供される。そして少数意見を重んじる民主主義の原則にのっとった自民党総裁選挙がいかなる場合においても、先ほど申し上げた緊急事態を除いて行われるということは、自分に有利不利と関係ない、誰のための党だという、国民の皆さんのための党であり、党員の皆さんのための党であるという原点に立脚すれば当然のことであって、私は総裁になれば自分の不利有利と関係ない、総裁選は常に正規に行うということであります。
So, well, it is speaking in hypothetical terms, but if I were the president of the LDP, I would aim to make sure that in any kind of situation other than the emergencies which I have just mentioned as well, the full election using the full democratic means would be implemented, other than these very, very rare cases as well. I believe that this is important in order to respect the rights of the members of the party, the members of the LDP, and also to ensure that they do have this full right to both the quality and the quantity of information which is being shared with them as well. So this election should be conducted based on the democratic principles.In any case other than these very extreme emergencies, this is the situation in which the LDP presidential elections should take place as well. The question of whether the election format is something which is in one's own interests or not, or is, you know, meritorious for oneself or not, is something which should not be part of it should not be a factor there as well. Rather, we need to remember that this is for the members of the party and for the people as well. This is natural, and this is the kind of election that if I were president of the LVP, I would ensure it does take place.
Khaldun Azhari, Panorama News and Arab News. Thank you, Shiva Sensei, for coming again to the club. According to most opinion surveys, you won the elections, actually, because you got the best support. And actually, I asked my cameraman to ask people in the streets, and about 80% they support you. But the election in Japan is done according to the faction loyalties, as we saw in the news recently. What is your impression about this? What is your message to the Japanese people who support you? And do you think the LDP now is not reflecting the people will in its elections for the president? Thank you.
アザリと申します。世論調査ですとか、私自身も街に出て一般市民のインタビューなどで、約 80% ぐらいの人たちが石破さんを総裁として支持しているというような数字があるというふうに認識しています。しかし、その総裁選というのは一般市民の意見というものではなくて、党の中の、そして派閥の中で決めるというようなやり方になっていると思うんですけれども、石破さんを支持している日本の国民の皆さんに対するメッセージをまず伺いしたいと思います。そして今の自民党は国民が思っていること、国民の考えていることをちゃんと反映できているかどうかについてのご意見もお願いします。
投票権はなくても、国民に、今回は党員にすら投票権がないんだ、投票権がなくても党員に訴えるというのは極めて大事で、今回やめときなって人も結構いたんです。こういうようなおかしなルールでお前は出るべきではない、ちゃんとしたルールの時に出るべきであって、今回はやめとけと、おかしいねあははと言っていて、その間に力を蓄えるのも道じゃないかと、私のことを思って真摯に忠告してくれた友人も多くいました。私も心が揺れないではなかったが、でもおかしいことはおかしいって言える機会が与えられるのはありがたいことじゃないですか。そういう、今も今日もね、もう中谷議員、平議員、前田議員来ていただいてるけれど、国会議員が推薦人になって大変なことなんですよ。その後ろには十数万という支持者がいるんですよ。主流派の方がポストはもらいやすいかもしれないんですよ。それでも一緒にやろうって言ってくれる人がいてですね、おかしいことはおかしいと言わないぐらいだったら政治家辞めます。やってる意味ないから、そういうことだと思っていますので、投票権はなくても党員に、国民の皆様方に何が正しいのかという自分が思うことを訴えていきたいと思っております。講談は何だったっけか。
じゃあまずそこまで訳
して、そこでいいの、はいはい、ごめん訳してください
すみません。So first of all, even of course, if the population, the people of Japan do not have the right to vote in this election, the same is said that actually not even the members of the party, the members of the LDP have the right to be voting in this election as well. However, that does not mean that I don't believe it's important to still appeal to the members as well. There were, in fact, many people, including people close to me, people are friends and so on, who advised me that when this election is being conducted under such strange rules, under these kind of rules, that I should not actually use my energies in running in this election, rather that I should, you know, wait until an opportunity when it is conducted under the proper methods in the proper way. I, of course, you know, I did consider or take on what they were suggesting. However, at the same time, I'm very thankful for the fact that I can stand up and say when something I do not believe is correct, when something is not right, to stand up and to be able to say that, to make that clear as well. Of course, today as well, we have many different members of the parliament who are here in support of me and supporting me in this election campaign as well. This is something which is not easy for them to be doing. They, of course, have behind them the many voters, the many supporters, and so on as well. And if they were supporting another candidate, perhaps it would be more easy for them to be having new positions in the new cabinet, which will be formed as well. However, if we are not able to be standing up and appealing when we think that something is not right, well, what is the point for us even to continue as politicians as well? So even without, in this particular case, this election, without the right to vote of the people and the members of the LDP, I still believe that it's very important for me to stand up and express, convey my appeal, my position to them.
We actually have a question from online from Simon Denyer of the Washington Post. He has two questions. First one is, Shinzo Abe is expected to make a statement today arguing that Japan should gain the capability to attack enemy missile bases. Is that wise? And the second one, listening to your opening remarks and talk about the problems that led to the war, I wonder if Japanese democracy is in crisis again under Shinzo Abe and Suga-san.
はい、次はメールの方で寄せているメッセージなんですけど、ワシントンポストのサイモン・デニア記者からの質問です。でこちら本日ですね、安倍総理が敵対攻撃能力についての、あ、敵基地、すみません、敵基地攻撃能力について、まあ、何か発信する、まあ、申し上げるということが期待されていると思うんですけれども、まあ、そのメッセージについて、まず賛成しているかどうかということをまず聞かせてください。そして先ほどですね、まあ、戦争が始まった背景にあったことですとか、まあ、戦争の始まりについての冒頭の発言を聞きまして、まあ、今、安倍総理、そして菅さんの下で、日本の民主主義は今も危機にあるというふうに感じますでしょうか。その2つお願いします。
ありがとうございます。敵基地攻撃能力は法的には可能だと思っています。今から17年前ですが、防衛庁長官の私が時にですね、どっかの国の指導者がこれから日本にミサイル攻撃加えるといい、ミサイルに燃料が液体で注入され始め、そしてミサイルが直立したと、そういう場合を想定すれば、相手が日本に対する武力攻撃に着手した、それが後戻りできない状態になったという評価が法的にはできますので、自衛権の行使は憲法的に可能だと考えています。
So first of all, regarding the capability to attack enemy missile bases, my interpretation, my understanding is that legally, under certain circumstances, certain conditions, this is actually possible given the current situation in Japan as well. 17 years ago, when I was the head of the Defense Department, when we had these discussions as well, that if it could be understood, if it could be judged that there was an attack coming from an enemy, the leader of another country had started a missile attack, and it had reached the point of, you know, the gas being injected into the missile and reached the point where it was no longer irreversible. So if it came clear that there was an armed act by an enemy state about to be conducted against Japan, then we could legally understand this as eligible for the utilization of the right to self-defense, even under the Constitution as it stands today.
しかし、相手の国の指導者がこれから日本に攻撃を加えると言わなかったらどうするか。今は固体燃料なので、ミサイル燃料を注入する何時間もかかるなんてことはない。そして移動式の発射台なので、どこから撃つかもわからない。コールドランチの高度ではないですよ、高い低いの高度ではないですね、どっかが間違えてたので、それは訂正しておきますが、コールドランチ、すなわち空気の圧力でミサイルを発射し、その後点火するという、こういう撃ち方だと発射台にダメージが与えられないので、何発でも撃てるわけですね。でそうすると、私が国会で答弁したような自衛権行使の状態と判断できるかどうかは、このことはかなり難しいと実は思っています。
However, at the same time, of course, the situation or the technology of these missiles and so on is different today as it was during that time as well. If we are not in a situation where the leader of the other country, the leader of the enemy country, were saying that we will attack Japan now, then to make this decision, to make this judgment that indeed this act is being done in a reversible way is very different. Of course, the nature of, for example, the gas which is being used in the missiles has changed from being liquid to solid gas. Therefore, it doesn't take these hours to conduct the injection in this time that the judgment judgment can be made in a definitive way. Also, the different aspects of, you know, the mobile launch vehicles being used now as well. Therefore, it's not as clear exactly as where exactly that launch is going to take from. It cannot be judged in that same kind of format as under the prior technology as well. Looking also at the different airplane launches and the way that this damage can be caused. Therefore, I think that what I'm also questioning, or what I've raised in the diet as well, is that how we judge such a situation when this can actually be utilized has become rather difficult.
どこに発射台があるかを今日本の能力では確定することは難しい。そして日本の単独の判断でそのような、相手基地あるいは相手国領域、ここは違うんで、この判断も精密に行わなきゃいけないんだけど、日本だけの判断で行えるという日米同盟だとも思っていない。
And however, as for example, determining, you know, where exactly this launch is taking place, where exactly these kind of things, I don't believe that it is easy to determine just under the capability or the capacity of Japan as well. Further, also for Japan just to take its own decision to conduct such an attack on enemy territory or an enemy base and so on as well, of course, needs to be done with very precision understanding, precision judgment. And I don't believe that that is something which Japan can do alone under the current US-Japan alliance as well.
F-35 で仮にやるとして、護衛戦闘機は必要だ。AWACS も必要だ。KC-767 も必要だ。そうすると、航空自衛隊の能力というものを相当の時間と相当の費用をかけてリニューアルしなければならない。仮にトマホークということになれば、今、イギリスにしか供与していないこのトマホークを日本にも供与してくれという交渉をアメリカとしなければならないし、発射基地相手目標がどこかはアメリカの情報によることになるのであるし、トマホークは飛行機なのでスピードが遅い。そうすると本当にそれが抑止力を持つかというのは極めて難しい課題である。
And of course, if we look at the different kind of technical capacity which would be needed to both make such judgments and make such acts as well. If we look, for example, if it were the case of an F-35, we would need various other equipment and so on the partition or the part of the air SDF as well, like KC-76 and so on. And it would take an extreme amount of both time and also finances, resource to be injected into the SDF to ensure that they would have such a capability as well. If we took, for example, if it were the case of the Tomahawk, this is, of course, something which under the current situation only the United Kingdom under the agreement and so on with the US has the rights for this kind of access to the information and so on. Therefore, we would need to enter once again in negotiations with the US for Japan also to have this same kind of information access and so on. But if it is the case of a Tomahawk, of course, this is, you know, it's an air vehicle, an airplane as well. Therefore, it is, you know, slow in this sense as well. So whether it really has this deterrence in this sense is something which we would question. There are these different also aspects, the technical aspects, which need to be considered as part of this.
でしかもまずイージス・アショは的なですよ。それと全く同じとは言わないが、能力を持つこと、そしてシェルターの整備を急ぐ、これは今すぐでもできることだと考えて、以上です。
However, I believe that what could be implemented very immediately would be something with a capacity similar to Aegis Ashore. I won't say exactly the same, but something with similar capacities to Aegis Ashore. And also looking at how to have full installation of shelters as well is acts which can be taken immediately.
Let's go to Mochizuki-san. Sorry, there was another question from Simon. Is Japan's democracy in danger?
失礼。あのね、日本の民主主義というのはかなり先ほど申し上げた点において参加する人の数、正しい情報、少数意見の尊重、かなり変質をしてきているのであり、ここはきちんと本来の民主主義を取り戻したいと思っている。
In regards to Japan's democracy, the second part of the question which was raised before, if we look at, for example, the number of people who are participating and also the full access, the full provision of information as well, I mean, this is something which we do need serious improvement on, and this is something which I believe that we need to implement.
Right, we've got time for a couple more questions, so Mochizuki-san.
東京新聞の望月と申します。今、総裁候補の一人である菅さんがですね、その説明責任に関連してなんですけれども、官房長官が日々会見しているので、日々のぶら下がりにも含めて、どうするかについて言及をされていません、それから国会にでの、臨時国会、なかなか開かないと安倍政権、批判されてましたけど、これについても、国会での出席日数が長すぎるんだという、反論をされてました。 まあ、極めて、まあ、菅総裁候補のお話を聞きますと、記者に対する説明責任はかなり後ろ向きな態度を表明していると感じます。で、一方でこの間政策発表の場で石破さん、まあ、フリーランスも含めた開かれた会見について言及されておりました。まあ、今日こういう場で記者会見をしている様子も含めてですね、今後その、まあ、日々のぶら下がり、それ臨時国会での対応、それから今なかなか こちらにいるようなフリーランスの方、神保さんのようなフリーランスの方が日々官房長官の場とか首相のぶら下がりの場に来るということは、まあ、現状では記者クラブの中でなかなかできない状況なんですが、そういったこう現在の記者クラブ制度の中でもっとこう変えていくべきじゃないかとか、自分が総理になったら、説明責任をこういう形で果たしていきたいとか、その点についての、お考えをお聞かせください。
はい、ありがとうございました。
まず英語で。
どうぞ。
すみません。From Tokyo Shimbun, my name is Mochizuki. I would like to ask a question in regards to accountability, and particularly in regards to accountability to the press and so on. This is a question, of course, Mr. Suga, one of the other candidates for the presidency of LDP. In his position as the chief cabinet secretary, he is having daily press conferences and so on. But there is a question, for example, he's saying that the prime minister is being forced to spend too much time in the diet as well, and he is perhaps taking a stance which is not so positive or forward-looking, for example, in terms of the explanation and accountability to the press as well. However, the other day in your policy speech, you mentioned about holding press conferences which are open and including also open to freelancers and so on. The fact that you're also speaking here today, I believe, is also evident of that. I would like to ask your opinion, for example, on this, the system of the, well, the press club system and how you see the accountability to the press and how you would change this if you were to become Prime Minister.
菅さんを念頭においてお答えをすることは差し控えたいと思っております。私としてどう思うかということですが、もちろん内閣記者会のそれぞれ内閣だけでなくて防衛省にも農林省にも記者クラブってなんですが、そこのご了解をいただければ私としてできる限り記者会見は手が上がらなくまでなるまでやりたいと思っています。ただ国務大臣の時間、総理大臣の時間というのは国民の時間でもあるものですから、それをどう有効に活用するかということなので、できたらこう手が上がらなくなるまでというと朝になっちゃったりすることもあったりしてですね、それはかなりつらかったりなんかしてですね、でそうするとお互いの良識というのことを言うつもりはないけれど、できるだけ質問は重複を避けて簡潔に、私は大体答えが長いと評判が悪いので、いかにして端的に答えるかということも大事なことだと思いますが、基本的にそのジャーナリズムの後ろには国民がいるのだよということを念頭に置きながら改善に努めていきたいと思っております。大臣の時も党役員の時も会見時間を制限したことは私はございませんが、同時に国民の時間であるということもよく認識をしたいところでございます。また日本国憲法によりまして、総理大臣並びに国務大臣は国会の要求があるときは国会に出席しなければならないとこう憲法に書いてあるものですから、よく空振りって私たちの言葉で言いますけど、呼ばれたけどずっと座ってたけど質問ないみたいなことがあってですね、でここはこれまたお互いの良識というのも何なんですけど、通告があったら質問してくださいなということなのです。そして事前に通告がないのにお答えできませんなんぞということは申し上げませんが、できれば通告があった方が丁寧な答弁はできるだろうねと思っていて、前日の夜10時ぐらいまでにはご質問出していただけるとありがたいなというふうに思っております。要するにこの時間は質問者の時間でもなければ答弁者の時間でもなければ国民の時間なのだという認識を強く持ちたいと思います。 それでいいね。はい。
So I'll refrain from responding particularly centered on Mr. Suga, but rather I will share my own opinion, my own stance in regards to this. During my time as a within the ministry and also when I've held official positions within the party and so on as well. And as I would want to do in the future, if we can also have the agreement of the various press clubs of each of the different ministries and so on as well, as I believe that press conferences should be held and should be continued until there are no longer any more hands, basically until all questions can be fully responded to as well. Of course, at the same time, however, I think we also do need to recognize the fact that the time of the Prime Minister is not time which belongs to him as an individual, but rather this is the time of the people of the country as well. Therefore, how to make sure that their time is utilized in the most effective way is very important. You know, if we said that all questions were to be answered until they stopped, there could be times when we would be there until the next morning. So we also need to think about the common sense in a mutual way as well to ensure that this is being done in an efficient way, mutual aspect as well. Also, for example, things that can be done to ensure that questions can be kept brief, that they're not overlapping, and that the respondent is also succinct and clear in their answers as well. This is things that we need to make steps towards as well. But I think it's very important for us to remember that, you know, behind journalists, behind the media, is indeed the people of the country as well. And there needs to be this response, this explanation to be made to them. And this is something which I believe that I would want to make improvements in regards to. When I myself was also a minister, I did not ever, you know, limit the time or the length of the press conferences and so on, but at the same time need to remember that this is the time which belongs to the people. In regards to the time of the Prime Minister attending the Diet, under the Constitution, of course, it is said that the Prime Minister does need to be in attendance when it is requested. However, there are, of course, these times as well when we see that they are requested to be there, but then there are no questions directed to them. You know, it's just being, you know, sitting there and not a useful way or a useful way to be spending the time as well. Therefore, I think that, for example, when the Prime Minister is being called to be in attendance in the Parliament, we should make sure that this time is being used for questions in an effective way. And, you know, I won't say necessarily that all questions must be submitted in advance. However, if they can be submitted, for example, by 10 p.m. the night before, this can mean that there can be a more meaningful and thorough response issued in the Diet as well.
Okay. Well, I'm conscious that Mr. Ishiba has a very busy schedule ahead of the election, so I think I'd like to call the session to a close here and thank him very much for sparing time during this very, very busy period.
なんかもらえるの使ったこともない。
ありがとうございます。
Please
everyone remain seated while our guest leaves the premises.
席についてままお待ちください。